Congratulations on a beautiful piece of cinema. Can you just tell us a little bit about some of the themes that you wanted to explore with this film, and particularly a little bit about the transformative performance from George in the title role of Tim?
Well, I was interested in making a film which is about kind of the themes of what happened to kind of the white working class in England. And that was drawn from when I was casting for the last film, that I would kind of go into these estates, these working class estates, and they seemed different to how I remembered them. You know, and once kind of manufacturing had been removed and they didn't have a steady flow of kind of employment, kind of what grew out of that. So I wanted to make something which explored these kind of thematic kind of elements, but do it through looking at a singular family. So a very recent history of the family over the last few generations, and what the potential kind of future for it was. And we do that through really the eyes of one character, which is Tim. And Tim was based on many different characters that I met when I was doing the research. And I knew normally I work with non-actors, but this time I wanted to work with an actor. And George was brought to me by the casting agent, and I had to spend a lot of time with him beforehand to be convinced that I wanted to go the route of working with an actor. But he shared a lot of qualities, I thought, with Tim, in that he's there's a sensitivity there, but there's also a kind of courageousness. There's also a very already kind of developed kind of moral compass. But what happens when he's in a situation where that moral compass is against what he naturally wants to do? What happens when you have an innocent in quite a guilty environment? I've always loved this English director called Alan Clark, and he kind of worked with Gary Oldman and Tim Roth and Ray Winstone at the start of their career. And when I decided I wanted to work with actors, it was about, okay, can we find people who I believe have that kind of charisma level and that kind of raw talent level that they can go on to do that kind of character work? But I wanted to use people who I hadn't seen in too much stuff before, so we had to look very, very hard. But as soon as Charlotte came in, it was immediate that she was extremely compelling. And I wanted her in the role of Lily, but it was also the same with Ben Dillaway as well.
And